through the ages, and saints and so forth have advised inactivity. And we haven't listened, at least the universities haven't listened. Yet they're willing to teach the poetry. It's a very strange situation. And when a familiar structure is banished, we don't need to give up the past as we go into the future. As we make changes, we don't have to lose. If we keep the notion of becoming abundant rather than scarce, to stay rich rather than poor, there is no reason to say we won't have any more harmony or common minor orchestration, or bassoon playing, etc. We can keep those things. Perhaps some of the rigor with which they have been taught in the past will have to continue for those things into the future or could. One wouldn't have to wipe the slates clean, so to speak, in order to start. One can add or multiply the possibilities. So that of an evening you could have a choice between hearing European string quartets, Indian music, Japanese music, rock and roll, etc. And it's very, very beautiful. This kind of richness is what we actually have now in our television, being able to change from one station to another. Now, as laser beams affect television, I understand there will be the possibility of multiplying the broadcasting stations. Since the bands needed will be much thinner. The result is that the future of television is great. You can have a television station that is relatively specialized, and when you turn to it, you can know what parts you do, rather than now not knowing more or less what you're going to get, except a local reading suddenly or other. But you would be able to do as the Japanese do in Tokyo now, when they go to a coffee house. They choose whether they go to the coffee house that plays Debussy, or the one that plays Beethoven, or the one that plays Mozart, or the one that plays Japanese music, or whichever one they choose. They have a great variety. On finding an audience for art, I think an important development in the future of communicating together would be the adding the screen to the coffin, and then accompanying it with, oh, each person will have, say, 1,000 sheets of material upon which anything can be recorded and subsequently erased. So that at any instant, everyone in the world would have access to 1,000 sheets of something. It could be reproductions of paintings or books or music or whatever, and you could easily give it up at any moment by erasing it, and have it again the very next moment if you felt well. It would just be dialed, and you could get what it was you needed whenever you needed it. Then we could drop out in the society all the purveyors of things, all the middlemen. Publishers, we wouldn't have any need for them. And if we improved our transportation means as we do this, having seen through reproductions, we might get the curiosity to see the original, and we could go quickly to it and see it and return home or move to another house. This is an application of the notion of flexibility.